I had no idea what happened. I was driving down the highway of my life, behind the wheel of my 1983 Mazda RX-7, the most beautiful sports car on the planet. I was young. I was single. I was free. The wind was blowing through my naturally blonde hair. My L'Oreal number 7. They called me the suicide blonde and, you know, died by my own hand. Oh, come on. I know you understand what I'm talking about. And I have no idea what happened. I got a little lightheaded. I think I blacked out. At one point, I was facing the wrong direction. And when I came to, I was back behind the wheel. Only it was a station wagon, a 1984 Volvo 240D, the ugliest car on the planet. And in the back seat were two car seats, and they were full. I meant to learn how to be a mother, but I forgot. There were two of them close in age, a boy and a girl. We called them Thing 1 and Thing 2. I had no idea what I was doing, but I figured it can't be that hard. A lot of people raise kids stupider people than me. Kardashian. Kardashian. And so I figured I'll just live my life, get on with it, and I'll go grocery shopping. Now, there is a special category of behavior that is the sole province of overtired toddlers.
And demons from hell.
And it's really hard to tell the difference. You know, you got the unnatural strength, the full body convulsions, the screeching, the thrashing around. Thing 1 was in full meltdown. I could not get that kid in the car seat. I had to go hand-to-hand combat on him, right there in the parking lot. Every time I put him in a seat, he'd flip out like a fish out of a bass boat. I finally muscled him in, and I swear, the better part of me said, you should comfort this child because he's screaming like he's being burned alive. But the other part of me, which is me, says, I'm just going to call Child Protective Services. CPS, unfit mother division, please. Can I hold on? If I could hold on, do you think I'd be calling you? The only thing that kept me from faking my own death and leaving the country was I kept hearing this car alarm. So I looked around. And I realized Thing 2 was missing, along with my groceries. It appeared she rolled away in the buggy while I was doing hand-to-hand combat with her brother, T-boned into the side of somebody's shiny black Mercedes, hence the car alarm. Oops. Sorry, rich guy. So we fled the scene at apparent low range of speed, and the cops never caught us. Now, the strong and adaptable survived, and we did. But I didn't do it by myself. I had a fabulous husband to go along with me. But I could never understand how he could treat Thing 1 and Thing 2 so differently. I called it the dad's dichotomy. Like, when they would get hurt around the house, Thing 1 would come running in, Daddy, Daddy! And my husband would say, now son, we'll stick your eyeball back in your head in just a minute. Can't you see your sister wants a cookie? And it was never more unclear how he could treat them so unequally when it came to money. When Thing 1 would come for money, his dad would say, a man has got to live up to his financial obligations. You cannot expect to develop any fiscal responsibility to come stick your hand out at me every time you want something. And I'd say, dear, he's 8 years old and he's asking for a popsicle. When Thing 2 wanted money, she'd go to her dad. He couldn't peel out the 20s fast enough. She played him like a cheap $2 banjo. So, you know, I thought when they got to be teenagers, they'd grow up, be a little more mature, be a lot easier. Maybe they'd fight less, but no. Something weird happened to their speech centers. Thing 1 became a functional, mute, nocturnal, and he spoke in mostly monosyllabic sentences for about 5 years. Yeah, no, fine, okay, pizza. That was what he said for about 5 years. And he disappeared inside his room, and he would only come out at night to feed, like some sort of elusive Sasquatch. I know this because I'd come down in the morning, and the kitchen looked like it had been ransacked by bears. But the speech center developed differently in Thing 2. which I attribute to the alien abduction in the seventh grade, which I understand is pretty common for 13-year-old girls. I put this very loving, happy child on the school bus one morning, and that afternoon, an identical-looking pond person got off, did nothing but snarl and cry and roll her eyes for the next 4 years. And incidentally, never shut up. She would argue about everything, and very frequently threatened to run away from home, which on those days was the only thing that kept me going. We were driving a minivan by then, and I could tell that the functional nocturnal mute and the snarling, eye-rolling alien were in the back because they were having their normal conversation. You're a butthead. No, you're a butthead. No, you're a butthead. And then, I have no idea what happened. I got a little lightheaded. It happened so fast, I don't remember it all. I think I might have blacked out. At one point, I was facing the wrong direction. When I turned around, the back seat was empty. And it was very quiet. But I swear, I heard the voice of the cat in the hat. The pages have turned. The days have gone by. These things, they grow wings, and they learn how to fly. So do not be sad when you come to the day and find that your things have all flown away. Instead, look with wonder in all that you do. There's magic ahead for thing one and thing two. That old emptiness, it ain't all that bad. You always were more than mom and dad. And if you get lonely, just wish on a star. And pretty soon, grand things will be filling your car. Mr. Toastmaster.